So we have our bands.
Yep.
And I want to start putting them on stages. They have to play.
Right.
All right. So I'm going to go into these records. Okay. So here's the band. Mm-hmm. And the stage field is blank, as is set time.
Yep.
And let's say we want to play, they're going to play what? 10 a.m. at stage 4 stage.
Okay.
Okay, so that's good. But what if I actually wanted them to play at two different set times? Like, you know, one at 10 a.m. and maybe again at 11, or maybe at a totally different stage. Is there a way to do that? It feels like I would have to create an entirely new band or something, a new record.
That's turning the relationship into something a little bit more complicated than just a simple one-to-many. Okay. So let me actually show you on the tablet what I mean.
Okay.
We're starting off with, we have our stage records. And I'm only representing it as one stage box, but this could be any of the stages that we have. Mm-hmm. And then each of these stages has a specific time we can book them for. So like 10 a.m., 11 a.m., 12 p.m., etc.
Sure.
And then for each of these time slots, you could have any sort of band playing there. So let's say we had, you know, our first band playing at 10 a.m., but then for your second band, you want them playing at 11 and 12.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. This is definitely getting more complicated as a data model.
So this is clearly not how we would represent something in Salesforce.
Right.
Instead of now having a one-to-many relationship, we have a many-to-many relationship, where a stage can have many bands, but bands can be playing at multiple stages at many times.
Right.
We're no longer tracking, you know, what stage are the bands playing at, but it's more so what time are they playing at those stages, because now there's another unique classification there.
So we've added this sort of like intermediate object.
Exactly. And what we'd call that intermediate object in Salesforce is a junction object. And what a junction object does is it represents every unique instance that we relate a band record to a stage record.
Okay, that makes sense. But what would, this isn't how we draw our schema in Salesforce, so what would this actually look like in Salesforce?
Right. Before, we had just stages and bands.
Right. And the relationship had that little line with the three forks at the end.
Right. Our stage had many bands. But now, we have stages, bands, and this junction object called set time.
Okay.
How do you think that this relationship will look when mapping it out?